I'm here just trying to wake up. Oh, and don't be stupid. We can be stupid, just leave.
I hear because each one of you, somewhere in your soul, wants to experience the music. The miracle.
I don't know if I like that one. Should we do it again?
Yeah, 5 or 6 more should do it.
Live from the Paradise Event Center of the Las Vegas Westgate Hotel, I'm Brian Selke, and this is the 2015 IAWTV Awards.
I have a story to tell. I have passion and ideas, but they've got the power and the money. How will I ever get it made? I do not know. I've pitched and it's the same thing everywhere I go.
Late to tell me about your thing.
Oh, 30 seconds.
Yes,
okay. Well,
29.
It's about a lesbian who meets her soulmate in space. And they defy all the odds in a gender-bending relationship. Oh, and they both happen to be unicorns.
Oh, it's fresh. Oh. It's exciting. It's new. No.
They say that it's too much of this and not enough of that. They say they like the twist, but the lead can't be fat. They say they like the pitch, but it's too niche. So what can I do? Psst. What is that?
Over here.
What? Wait a minute. Who are you?
I'm Collier Landry. I'm a cinematographer.
Get out! Collier Landry, a cinematographer! What are the odds?
Well, it is Vegas, right?
Well, it is Vegas, yes, of course. What do you want?
I can help you shoot your project.
You can? Wow, yeah. That would be excellent. But, you know, I'm gonna need a lot more than just a camera.
Everything you need is in the web series community.
I love that show.
Oh, yeah. Not to be confused with the web series, comma, Community.
On Yahoo!
Look, it's Paula and Kyle from the New Adventures of Peter and Wendy.
Whoa!
Hi, hi. Yeah, you can do that on the web.
On the web?
Yeah.
Yeah, on the web, you know, the interwebs, the triple dub, that, you know, that series of tubes.
Yeah, yeah, of course, the World Wide Web. That's a fantastic idea, but, well, how would I begin?
Well...
You're not the one and only, a lonely pioneer. There have been those who came before and broke this new frontier.
And since we're talking loneliness, there's Lonely Girl 15. And Lonely Girl meets Lonely Girl and anyone but me.
And don't forget Joss Whedon, Brad Bell, and Issa Rae. We're so thrilled she built the guild, the one and only Felicia Day.
No way!
They got it done. And so can you. You can do it on the web. You can do it on the web. You can tell your story your way. You don't need permission, no way. You can do it on the web.
Oh, wait a minute. I've got a cell phone camera right here. Let's just start shooting.
Ah, let's not be too hasty.
Well, you still got a plan for locations and budget and talent.
Oh, my. Well, gosh. Well, what do I do next?
Oh, it's simple.
Oh.
You've gotta write it and cast it and do production schedules.
You'll need insurance, release forms, permits, and post-production.
You'll need clearances, social media, you'll film cut and upload it.
And oh yeah, you're probably gonna have to kickstart it.
Well, kickstart? No, I silkscreened those myself! Oh! Those are Hanes. Right. Oh gosh, but I gotta do all of this myself?
No. Hire a sound guy.
Oh.
Oh, and an unpaid PA, too.
Come on. I mean, only a kid would be so dumb. Oh, hi, little girl.
You can do it on the web. You can tell your story your way. You don't need permission, no way. You can do it on the web.
So I can get my series made.
Can't promise you'll get paid.
Yeah.
But I'll tell the story my way. I can do it on the web.
You can do it on the web.
Show it all around the world.
You can tell your story your way.
We can do it just for girls and see just how great we can be.
Do it on the web.
You can do it on the web.
I can do it on the web.
You can do it on the web. We can do it on the web.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Tony Sag and Drama Desk Award winner Roger Bart.
Thank you. Welcome to the 2015 IAWTV Awards. First of all, thank you to our orchestra. Thanks, guys. And also to the cast of Newsies that did this on their night off. Wow. What a group. And how about that David H. Lawrence, the 17th from Heroes? My goodness, who knew we could knock out a show tune like that? Wow. I'm exhausted. Good night, everybody. No, listen, I'm so proud to be here. I'm gonna share something personal with you. I've never told anyone this before, but when I was a boy, I'd go to sleep every night and I'd look out at the stars and I'd make a wish that I could one day host a web television award show as part of the New Media Expo at NAB in the Westgate Hotel / Convention Center in Las Vegas, Nevada. Yeah. And guess what, folks? That little boy's wish came true tonight. Now, this evening we have presenters from 6 different countries, which really should make for a very cool multicultural after party where people from different parts of the world can all pretend that they've seen each other's series. It's a wonderful evening ahead. Yeah, there's lots of nominated shows here from Canada tonight. Yeah, there's a Space Riders Division Earth, 6 nominations. Now, in case you're one of those that have not seen it, Space Riders is not really a kid's show. It was like as if, you know, Bert and Ernie had a love child with a Power Ranger and it cusses. So, thank you very much for that. Another of our big nominees is from Quebec. It's called The Banks. Now, I don't even really quite know where to begin on that one. You've got some sick fuckers up there. I mean, you must be the salmon or something. He bashes her head with a rock. It's just twisted shit. Anyway, oh yeah, and this one, Out With Dad, which I like to call, being that it's from Quebec, it's Out with Dad. It's when a teenage girl comes out to her single father, and that is, it's okay, it's really just nice. It's so sweet. It's so beautiful. It's beautiful work, and I highly recommend it. And coincidentally, it was written and stars the guy who wrote what I'm saying right now. It's so wonderful, and if you haven't seen it, you should really tune in. We're paying tribute tonight to the pioneers of web series tonight. Now, these are the people who started when the term net neutrality was used to describe fishing in international waters. I like that joke. Anyway, the special thing about a web series, really, is that anyone can have one. They're like the guns of online entertainment, you know? And similar to guns, does that mean that everyone should have one, really? I mean, not to get too political here, but if I walked in on my kid playing around with a web series, I'd never be able to forgive myself. Please just lock it up in a safe. Anyway, web series television has come a long way in the last 4 years. The House of Cards is on its third year, their third season, and technically speaking, it is a web series that has gotten zero nominations, so you can suck on that, David Fincher. Yeah. The Fine Brothers just schooled your candy ass, okay? Yeah. There's lots of great nominated shows here tonight. The Real Housewives of Horror is one of my faves. All right, awesome. Four nominations directed by Sandeep Parikh. Sandeep, you know, he started with this series called The Legend of Neil, which is about a guy who is sucked into his Nintendo after he asphyxiates himself with a game controller while masturbating. It's so relatable. Speaking of video games, video game high school's leading the pack tonight. Man, seven nominations. I got no digs for that. It's a very, very cool show. Now, who's here from Sequestered? Oh, thank God, somebody out there. All right. Well, guess what? You've been served. Okay. Or I guess you haven't, because we don't really have any food. I apologize about that in advance. Just keep drinking. How about Oposto do Sexo? The Opposite of Sex, a web series from Brazil, nominated for Best Comedy. And I say, you know what, nice twist, because my Brazilian friends, they never think about sex, let alone the opposite of it. Kids React, it's such a great and funny show. You know, sadly, the cast, I'm sad to announce this, cast can't be here tonight because they have a math test in second period tomorrow. Sorry for everybody. I hope you're watching at home. Did you see the Argentinian series? It got six nominations. Dymonium? It's actually Dymonium. I apologize, Dymonium. I don't really know what they're saying, but damn it, it looks good. Player Piano has six nominations. Congratulations, guys. It's awesome. It's awesome. It's getting people excited about music in a way like no one has ever seen before, and that is what the web is about, isn't it? Creating videos that are completely original, you know? And tonight we're gonna honor the best of web video. The nominees were selected by an international jury consisting of 170 people, and the recipients of the awards were chosen by the membership of IAWTV. Now, the first nomination... Yeah! Oh, my God. No, I'm just a host. Oh, my God.
I just wanted to tell him... I really like his work is all. Well, ladies and gentlemen... From Heroes, David H. Lawrence the 17th.
Thank you. Nothing quite captures the imagination like a journey through a fantastical land, an adventure in a galaxy far, far away, or a group of ordinary people becoming heroes. Tonight's nominated series show us the true imaginative spirit of today's online creators and prove that anything is truly possible. The nominees for Best Genre Series are...
Best Genre Series. Caper. Demonium. Grayson Earth 1. The Gambit.
Stay with you.
SOS, Save Our Skins.
Something.
You know, I just realized I auditioned for every single one of those series. And all of the directors and producers had the good sense not to cast me, which was great. And the winner is SOS, Save Our Souls, Save Our Skins.
Definitely should have cast him. Thanks so much. What a great honor. It's great to see so many Canadians out here in the middle of the desert. So thanks to the Independent Production Fund in Canada, BBCW, and all our producing partners, Henry Normal, Catherine Tate, and Jonas Diamond here.
Yeah, I just really want to thank Nat Saunders and Chris Hayward, the creators of the show, who are absolutely amazing. This is a UK-Canada co-production, so not just Canada, but also the UK. So thanks very much. It's a great honor and really amazing nominees to be, you know, celebrating this award with. So thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the stars of Grayson Earth 1, John Okoda, and Stephen McCain.
Music is a beautiful expression of feelings and emotions that speaks to our hearts. Music also speaks to us in a way that complements what we see.
All these nominees have created auditory works of art that enhance the world we see on screen. And the award for Best Original Music goes to...
Best Original Music. Henry Dalton, Paul Cope, Alex Cornish, and Christopher George, Future Duck.
Inside these four walls, I feel so insecure.
Gordy Hobb, Aileen Quincy, and Jason Curry, My Two Black Girlfriends.
To wipe all my tears back at
Chris Edgar, Steve's Quest, the musical.
I'm a dreamer. The future is bright.
Your wallet is light.
David Todorik, Space Janitors.
What's our ETA to the Rebel base?
6 days, sir.
6 days. 6 days.
Jay McCarroll, Mark Little, Tyler Kite, Alex Kashkin, and Matt Beckett. Space Riders Division Earth.
As the feelings collide, grab the hero inside, and it's time for that hero.
You want to hold that for a second?
Sure.
And the award for Best Original Music goes to Gordy Hobb, Alan Quincy, and John Curie, My Two Black Girlfriends.
So Aileen and team couldn't be here, so we'll accept on their behalf. We are very grateful to you guys and...
Very grateful to Aileen Quincy for involving us in her original concept and vision. And thank you very much to the IAWTV.
Because let's make some more music. All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Please welcome, from Misdirected, Lauren Mora, and from Shameless, Rena Strober.
You are the storytellers, the visionaries. The impact of your work on the web is perhaps as great as the printing press, the radio, or the moving picture.
And nowhere but on the web can you find the LGBT community, non-English-speaking actors, minority superheroes,
woo-hoo,
and female-led casts standing side by side.
The ensembles nominated tonight help to highlight one of the reasons the work on the web is like no other medium.
The nominees for Best Ensemble Drama are...
Best Ensemble Performance, Drama.
Yanni Boudreau.
Nikki and Nora.
Who are you people?
We're the people that are going to return to the NOPD.
Out with Dad. Sequestered.
Caretaker of the governor's son. The man accused of murdering him
for an $80 million rent.
The Banks.
Oh, we are not good.
Okay, un cadeau.
We Are Angels.
Ah, they all look awesome. And the award goes to Out with Dad.
Thank you so much to the IAWTV and the members for electing our performances and the wonderful cast that aren't here, Kate and Caitlin, and I can't even begin to name the rest right now.
But we know that they're all watching at home in Toronto and Calgary, and so, hey guys, we're so sorry that you couldn't be here right now.
We miss you so much, and we're gonna drink a lot on your behalf.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yay! The nominees for Best Ensemble Comedy are
Best Ensemble Performance Comedy. Caper.
12. Seriously, that movie? No, that movie was awful. Hey,
Real Housewives of Horror.
Ending to another post show. So join them for season.
Space Janitors.
You guys complain too much. I'm having a great time.
SOS, Save Our Skins. Video Game High School.
Did the school get bigger or did we get smaller?
Hey, and the award goes to Real Housewives of Horror.
Sorry, we're all wearing heels, so it took us a long time to get over here. Thank you so much for this award. Oh, thanks. She's periscoping us. Thanks to Nerdist. They let us make this crazy series about us being married to serial killers and ghosts and stuff. And thanks to Sandeep, who makes this super funny. And thanks to Kevin Barrera, who helped make this series possible. And thanks to the girls. And this is like an amazing cast, and it's not very often you get to work with like amazing, cool women who make things really amazing. I'm just gonna say amazing a bunch of times and pretend like I'm not nervous. Okay.
You have to say anything?
No, no.
Okay, thanks. That's it. Yeah. Bye.
Bye. Thank you. We love you, Priya.
Here with a special presentation is creator and star of Pairings, Ed Robinson.
Good evening. This is a special night for the IAWTV. Not only are we sharing the best of 2014 with the world, but we're also here to honor those shows that helped pave the way for web series to become the streaming series that they are today. This new storytelling medium was created from the passion to tell stories and for an audience to see them. It's also a medium that was inspired by voices that were limited to supporting roles in traditional media, but knew they could take the lead. And now those voices are loud, recognized for their worth, and sought out for the audiences that they bring. Even as many traditional media creators enter the space, we will always have something special to hold on to, that our work is the foundation on which this rapidly growing medium has been built. For over a decade, we have believed in the power to tell stories on the web, and now, so does everyone else. This first video is a tribute to all those shows that took a chance to tell their stories online, often influencing future creators with their unique perspective or by telling stories in a unique way. We thank creators who lent us their work and to our editor, Pam Picard, and to two-time IAWTV award-winning composer, Rob Gokey, for helping bring this video to life. Tonight, we celebrate not only our achievements, but the creating history, our history, and it's a history that it is an absolute honor to be a part of.
I'm not losing him, he's right there!
Oh, oh my God!
Hey, you're doing good, man! Keep it going, keep it going!
He's getting really close, guys!
Hang on, everyone! Shit, watch out! Hey, don't!
Pretty good shot, huh, Daddy?
Not bad, baby. But it's easy when nobody's shooting back at you. You ready?
You gonna see your boyfriend? Girlfriend? Really? Hey, it's cool.
Is it?
Isn't it?
I still feel the same way I felt back in the fall. More strongly even than I did then. So if you just want to be friends or say thank you for recent events, then that.
Prom is the single most important night of our lives. It's like a real life fairy tale.
And the 2007 Edward Adams Prom Queen is...
You're terrifying me. You're honestly, you're scaring me.
Will
right
you stop
here.
Him?
I am stopping him.
Yes.
Here I am.
Stop. You're not stopping me. Oh, I'm fantastic. I'm amazing.
Can I sleep with you?
You can't even think about sleeping with me.
I would amaze you.
That statement amazes me.
My name is Donnie, and you suck at Photoshop. You do. You're awful, and that's why you're here. All right, let's get started.
Go on, Nesta!
Beat our mouth. Put the brakes on, all right?
Hey guys, I'm Zadi, and this is Epic Food.
This is Epic Food.
This is Epic Food.
You told me your past was taken by thieves. Since then you've been running in search of release.
Max just said he wants me to do that thing, you know, with... three guys and a little guy that used to be a chick.
Yeah, no.
But I said, I don't do that.
Oh, I know, Asia. I spoke with your agent. Don't even worry about it. Nobody is going to be putting 3.5 of anything anywhere, okay? Especially not in you.
I think he was about to jerk off, too. Look, look at this. Cool melon body lotion.
That's my lotion.
That's your lotion.
That means he went into your bathroom, bypassed the unscented brands, and went straight for the ones that he wanted his balls to smell like cool melons.
What? This isn't mine.
Save it, pervert.
George, these are one of these key moments in life. You just have to seize the day, you know, crap a dime.
Carpe diem?
That's what I said.
Seaward, we got a bit of a boss battle situation here. I mean, can we pause maybe a little bit later and get back to the fight?
They left.
Excuse me?
Yeah, I woke up and then this, and they flew off.
They can fly?
Hang with me in my MMO. So many places we can go.
The only reason you had fun with that character at all is because we were a guild and we play together.
I mean, after school.
Oh, hey, I got it.
Oh, ding. I have a backup plan to get a new computer.
You're lying again.
You're right.
Oh my God!
Hot people trying to look ugly, and ugly people trying to look hot.
Hyper dangerous.
Dangerous. Please, we can't even walk down the street without starting a trend.
Totes.com.
Oh, spring! Obama is president. Everything's gonna be fine now.
You cannot replace a true love. And that's how I feel about pickles.
Excuse me, I hate to interrupt, but is everybody pretty much ready for a sea of blood?
That was the worst throw ever.
No, you don't know him. You don't know anything about him. What is your problem, Catherine? Hey!
Hey.
Yeah. That's pretty inspiring stuff. How about a hand for the pioneers, man? Seriously. So much amazing work in such a short period of time. You know, this show makes me feel so good. It makes me realize the importance of the community and the importance of family. I think really right now would be a great opportunity to call your father. No, really, I mean, seriously, call him. Like, don't wait. Call him right now. You know what? I'm gonna call mine right now. Let's see what's going on here. Hang on a second. It's ringing. Hang on. It takes a while for him to pick up. So, still ringing. Dad. Hey, it's Roger. Hey. Hey. Hello. Okay. I think you should still call your father. Okay. So, from Star Trek now, New Voyages, we have Rivka Ravenwood and Mr. JTS-TV himself, Carter Mason.
Good evening. With people watching our shows on everything from devices they can hold in the palm of their hand to home entertainment systems and the big screen in movie theaters, having good sound is a must.
And bad sound can tank an other great...
These are the former. This is not an award for bad sound. The nominees for best sound are...
Best sound. Guidestones, Sunflower Noir. Player piano. Space Riders, Division Earth. Sweethearts of the Galaxy.
Next, you can do anything.
Caitlin!
How do you two like to dress as characters from comic books? I always wanted to be a superhero. A superhero?
The Division. Video Game High School.
We get smaller.
He doesn't realize that I'm a sociopath who cares more about video games than movies.
And the award goes to Player Piano. Hey everybody, I'm Tom Gray. I am the producer and director of Player Piano. None of our sound team can be here tonight because they all have jobs and make way more money than I do. But for Sonia, our composer and pianist, Barry Neely, who does our sound design, and Guillermo Marin, who does our sound mixing, I want to accept this award for them. So thank you.
I'm not sure why he just tried to give us back the award. Sure, I'll take that. When we think of animation, we often think of things designed to make us laugh.
This year, however, we can't award this category without first acknowledging the loss of one of animation's shining young stars.
A couple of months ago, the creator of Ruby, last year's winner for Best Animation, Monty passed away tragically.
Those who knew Monty have said that the best way to honor him is to keep creating new works like Monty himself did.
And the nominees for Best Animation
are... Best Animated Series. Fatty Littlehead, Space Ranger.
Poopinjar of Justice.
Fifi Cat Therapist. Future Duck. He is a duck for the future. Steve's Quest, the musical. 63 Towers of Steel and Hover. The most popular girls in school.
Okay. And the award goes to Steve's Quest, the musical.
Thank you. Oh, my goodness. I want to thank my brother, Tim Edgar, who would tell me when something that I wrote sucked and would help me to revise it accordingly, and to all the wonderful cast and crew of Steve's Quest. Let's make more online musical theater.
Please welcome the co-creators of the new adventures of Peter and Wendy, Kyle Walters and Sean Deloach.
Doing live television, as you have witnessed tonight, is ballsy. Anything can happen, from an act of God to a distracted host.
Whoa,
to...
I am digging this bow tie.
Oh, thanks.
Not if people rock the bow tie anymore.
I know, right?
Do you tie it yourself, or do you have like a team of people?
Oh, no, my mom did this, yeah.
Your mom's such a sweet lady.
She's great, yeah.
Oh, she's got the most charming smile.
Right. Yeah.
She's enchanting.
Oh, I know, she's great. Are you Facebook friends with her?
We are Facebook friends.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
She pokes me a lot, which is weird.
Yeah. Oh. Sorry, I think it's happening without us.
Best live series. After Buzz TV's So You Think You Can Dance after show. AMC Movie Talk.
My wife and I, we are a pair of those, like, creepy.
Mom Cave Live. Super Geeked Up.
That's what we're about to do right now.
What's Trending?
You incite screams.
I'm just glad it doesn't happen every day.
And the winner, and the award goes to AMC Movie Talk.
It is incredibly humbling for us to be in a room with so much talent. People create stuff for the online world and the online space. We want to give a special thank, of course, to AMC for supporting everything we do, our producer Justin Gardner, who can't be here tonight, to the fans who follow us and create an online community for all of us to enjoy, participate in. I got to thank my wife Anne. Of course, I'm going to be in trouble when I get home. And to all of you, thank you so much for creating stuff that entertains and challenges us every single day. And of course, to the fans of AMC Movie Talk, who just support us every day. Thank you very much.
And the rest of our co-hosts and panelists, John Schnepp, Christian Harloff, Mark Ellis, everybody, thank you.
Of course, pre-recording your show doesn't make things any easier, right?
Yeah, I mean, you've got, multiple takes, post-production, pickups, lots of people to deal with.
However, sometimes pre-recording does make things easier. For example, this was pre-recorded, and Kyle and I aren't really here.
And the nominees for Best Pre-Recorded Hosted Series are...
Best pre-recorded hosted series. Larry King Now.
You can read the freaking phone book and they're like, Larry, keep going.
Late to the Game. Girl, you know it's true.
Nah,
Politicking.
Potential nominees.
I'm governor-centric. What little credit for...
Sports Jeopardy.
2014, this boy wonder.
Getting all day.
Tabletop.
And John's drinking water right now. Felicia is most...
And the award goes to... Larry King Now.
Hi, everyone. Oh, my gosh. Hey. I'm Scott Brown. I'm Larry's director. He couldn't be here today. He had a speaking engagement in Buffalo. But he wanted to say from the bottom of his heart, this is an honor. You know, he said before that he started in radio, then he moved to TV, and now on the internet, he loves it more than ever. He says that more times than I can tell you. He would want to thank his crew, his entire producers, especially Jason Rovo, his executive producer, and to thank all of you for this incredible honor. Thank you very much.
Okay, so as I'm sure you're aware, it's the 4th Annual International Academy of Web and Television Awards tonight, but you may not know that it wasn't always the case. Last year was the 3rd International Academy of Web Television Awards. The year before that was the 2nd. And before that, the 1st. In fact, you'll find that it's the definition of annually, once a year, you know, yearly. So my point is that, you know, we're really at the beginning of our journey, and just 4 years in, we've seen such incredible progress, both technically and creatively, and you and the people next to you are the new pioneers. Now, someone has to be the first to blaze a trail and try something new, you know, like the first time somebody made a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or sailed across the ocean to discover that the Earth was indeed not flat and who didn't befriend someone for inviting them to play Candy Crush, you know, so. Now, as you probably don't know this, but I was in a web series myself, 9 episodes of Easy to Assemble. With wonderful Ileana Douglas. What you might not know is that I was actually the star of a number of pioneering web series. Of course, there's what I'm most famous for is The Guild. It was really, that was before, I had some work done during that time. You know, a lot of you don't know that I detoured from that afterwards and I wanted to try something just a little bit edgier, you know, something fun. It was called Blue Movies. That was awesome. I look actually pretty good. Then I went to kind of the YouTuber route, you know, with my drunk kitchen, which I do love. I do love my Bartos. I do. And finally, there was a series that was dearest to my heart, The Misadventures of Awkward Black Girl. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you didn't think I wasn't going to probably be the other. Yeah, that would be really tasteless, you know. And so now I'd like to introduce the chairman of the IAWTV and the executive director of tonight's awards, my bosses, Jeff Burns and Jonathan Robbins, and they have no taste, they hired me, so let's come.
Jonathan and I both love superheroes, but the real superheroes are the creators we're honoring tonight, those who pioneered our journey here, and those who will blaze our path forward.
The awards tonight are not just about the nominees.
They're about the community.
We applaud every web series creator out there, and thank you for having the courage to pursue your dreams and creating some of the most innovative content in any medium.
And to make it a little easier to pursue those dreams, we'd like to introduce two people to talk about a great opportunity for web creators.
Please welcome the executive director of the ITV Fest, Philip Gilpin Jr.
And IAWTV board member, Frank Chindamo.
So as we all know, funding is often the biggest roadblock for us to make a web series.
The IAWTV has partnered with ITV Fest to help break down that barrier.
Yeah. Dover, Vermont is the home of ITV Fest, and as you can see, well, they didn't put it up yet. It's a very photogenic place. Trust me, I live there. It's beautiful. You want to visit. If you shoot your web series there, you'll be eligible for one of our 4 grants. We're giving away cash that are help you get your project started. You can find out more information about these grants and apply for them at itvfest.com.
And speaking of applying, if you'd like to join the IAWTV, see me tonight. And on the subject of beautiful backdrops, we're here to present the award for Best Cinematography.
Best Cinematography. Stephen Parr, player piano. Jeff Barklage, Star Trek Phase II, New Voyages. Arnaud Damas, The Banks. Matthew Whiteman and Wes Pratt, Timekeeper. John Salmon, Video Game High School.
And the award goes to...
Stephen Parr, player piano. This is where those morning workouts pay off, huh? Stephen, you look different in person.
Thank you. So I'll accept this on behalf of Stephen and Tom. Tom actually just accepted our last, but here he is. Thank you, Tom. I was not the right person for this.
Oh, okay, sorry. Stephen is not here. He is off on a feature. He, as well as my sound team, make more money than I am, so they could not be here tonight. But Stephen is amazing. Our other cinematographer, Ryan Meyer, is also amazing. And yeah, that's it, thank you.
The host of AMC Movie Talk, John Campia, and the star of Teenagers, Chloe Rose.
The editor is like a master chef, taking various ingredients and putting them together to hopefully make a work of art.
Let's take a look at five masterful creations that even Gordon Ramsay would approve of. The nominees for Best Editing are...
Best Editing. Eric Wan, The Division.
Are you all right?
What? Hey, whoa! I just lived
Tom here. Smalley, Anthony Baird, and Lawrence Jackman, Guidestone, Sunflower Noir. Sean Becker, Hench. Mike Reisiker, Ruby Sky PI, The Maltese Puppy.
Well, I just rescued you.
Not quite rescued.
Freddie Wong and Matt Arnold, Video Game High School.
And the award goes to... Tom Smalley, Anthony Blair, Lawrence Jackman for Guildstone's Sunflower Noir.
Amazing to be back up here. Really want to thank Anthony Baird, Lawrence Jackman, Tom Smalley, Guidestone Sunflower Noir. Amazing production, our intrepid leader, Jay Ferguson. This is our second season. It's just been an amazing journey for us and amazing that we can be celebrated here tonight at the IAWTV Awards. I really want to thank the Academy for this great honor. Thank you very much.
It's time for Super Geeked Up. Here are Tonya Dodds and Nicole Wright.
Visual effects can help create a world unique to each series. They can be done so well that often an audience member may not even know that they're looking at an effect.
And whether it's students attending an unusual school, people battling demons, or flying through space, this year's nominees demonstrate how far visual effects have come in our industry. In fact, we're using some right now. I bet you can't even tell that Nicole is actually a visual... No.
And the nominees are...
Best Visual Effects. Demonium. Space Janitors. Space Riders, Division Earth. Star Trek Phase II, New Voyages. Video Game High School.
Here's your breath. Who cares more about video game?
And the award goes to...
Daemonium.
Wow, this is surreal. I really don't talk in front of people that much, but on behalf of the Daemonium team, these talented guys from Argentina who picked me to be here for them, thanks. Thanks to the Academy, thanks everybody who voted for us, the judges, and thanks Las Vegas, and thank you everybody. Daemonium team, keep an eye out for us, thanks.
We have some
Tanya.
Really
great... Tanya!
What?
Okay. What do you call cheese that's not yours? Nacho cheese!
You are really excited to present the award for Best Children's Series, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
Awesome. And the nominees are...
Best Children's Series. Angie's Logs, the Invaders web series. Fifi Cat Therapist. House of Robots.
Never ruined any kid's life ever. Stop!
Kids React.
That is literally everywhere.
Ruby Sky PI, the Maltese puppy.
I'm nervous.
And the award goes to... Ruby Sky PI, the Maltese puppy. Woo! Is anyone here? Oh,
thank you. I have nothing to do with this series except that I know Jill who makes it, and she wanted me to pick this up and say thank you to the UMDC and the IPF who finance her and to her amazing cast and crew. I agree, they're amazing. On behalf of Jill, thank you very much.
Please welcome, for a special presentation, pioneering web producer Jenny Powell.
Tonight, as we continue to celebrate the year's best work and also the work that helped pave the way, we want to acknowledge the one thing that everyone has in common. We all entered this space because we were inspired by someone or something to create web content. With score by Rob Padgett and edited by Amanda Mitro, in a series of three videos that we will play throughout the night, we asked new media creators why they decided to make content. Online, this is what they told us.
So I was inspired to take a crack at making web series by a little show called Clark and Michael that Michael Cera and Clark Duke have made. And I saw it and I thought, wow, it's amazing that we can be doing stuff like that online. I'm gonna give it a try.
Then it was folks like Big Fantastic and Felicia Day with The Guild, and even, you know, Yuri Baranovsky and Break a Leg. They kind of took it from, you know, kind of the webcam, literally, you know, an iMovie, that sort of lower quality stuff, to, at the time, what looked like a professional TV show or movie.
And there was this lady named Felicia Day making stuff for the web, and I thought, oh, I could do that.
People like Felicia Day, who were out there making their own content for a very specific audience, and that really inspired me.
And when we were filming the first episode of Gold, that's when The Guild dropped, and people lost their minds.
Kim Easy. I actually wasn't really into online video. I was not a filmmaker. I was a gamer, an online addict, but I never thought about making something myself until I showed my script to The Guild. She read it and said, you should do this online because that's where the people who like your show are.
Obviously, Felicia Day with The Guild, who did a lot to get everything started. Michael Buckley with What the Buck, which I found absolutely hilarious and I still listen to Elaine Carroll, Very Mary Kate. If you haven't checked out Very Mary Kate, it is absolutely hilarious. Brad and I quoted jokes back and forth to each other all the time. It's one of the shows that he actually told me to watch to help me get my mind around the idea of making online content.
I think that tends to always happen with a new medium. It's written off and it's not legitimate, you know, it's not the legitimate theater. It's those Nickelodeon films or what have you, and then, you know, the Oscars are the king of Hollywood for a while, and then it's all about the Emmys and television. That's where the real important work is, and I think we're extending that concept now again, the 21st century, and making entertainment connected.
And I'm kind of old school, so I go back all the way to the mid-2000s, so my influences were shows like The Berg and Break a Leg and Something to Be Desired out of Pittsburgh, or Tiki Bar TV. That show goes back even further, and they're still online. All those shows are still online. You can go and watch them, and you should watch them. It's like watching history in glorious standard definition.
That was Dan Harmon. He had a website called channel101.com, and I started watching all these shows on it, including this series called House of Cosby's, and I thought it was hilarious. And I thought, well, I could do this too, and I don't have to use his website. I could just build my own and have a show. So we started making The Berg, and this thing YouTube came along, so we also uploaded it to there, and the rest is history.
I think Joss Whedon was a huge influence on me to not only continue the Guild after, but to create a family online. That was kind of why I kept making content online, is because of the community and feeling like I am making content for specific people who really like what I do. And I learned about that kind of community from being on Buffy. I was introduced to so many fans who showed me that content can be more than just passively consumed. It can be actively part of someone's life.
The rule at the time was you can't put anything long form online, only sketches, only things that are a minute or less. And our episodes were 20 minutes and they were viewed more than our shorts. So I think anyone who broke the rules sort of helped inspire us to do the same.
Please welcome star of The Gambit, Raj Babsar, and the creator of Oposto Do Sexo, Leandro Silva.
Hello. So Raj, I saw you at the Olympics, man. You got a bronze medal in gymnastics. That must take a lot of hard work and concentration.
Definitely. It also takes a lot of dedication, training, and timing. And then you have to make it all look easy, just like our nominees in Best Male Performance in a Comedy.
Best Male Performance in a Comedy. Matthew Werkmeister, Chris and Josh.
You got a chance, but I have to go now. Toby's stupid. I need to do this. Don't you die on
me. I'm not dying!
Shane Savage, Chris and Josh.
Arguments invalid. Time you get decapitated and match like your mom's mashed potatoes as she holds a detonator while she caters for Darth Vader. Oh, you like your mom?
I do. Angela Lozada, get some.
Enough, all right? Like, for instance, today I found out that my wife is a gay man. But you know what? I'm cool with that. I'm fine with it. I'm not threatened at all.
Algin Abella, Hunter and Hornet. Jonathan Silver, LARPs, the series.
You force my hand.
Am I still in control of my actions?
Have I told you what to do yet?
Right. I'm not one of them, Corellia. Not yet.
And the award goes to Matthew Werkmeister, Chris and Josh.
G'day guys, I'm not Matthew Werkmeister, this is Matthew Werkmeister. I'm Shane Savage, I was also nominated. So on behalf of Matt, I would like to dedicate this award to me. No, but in all seriousness, we have such a blast on this show, and this is a real honor. So thank you to everyone. Thank you to everybody here for making your own stuff. We had over 60 people work on this season for zero money. It was a passion project. So to represent them here is just kind of a testament to everybody's work. So thank you again. And I'm here by myself, so make friends with me and have a drink later. Cheers, guys. Thank you.
From Future Duck, Henry Dalton. And from Emma Approved, Shilpi Roy.
Speaking as a woman working in comedy who's had to hide for many years behind a fake beard and overly constricting sports bra, there are some amazing female comedy performances being celebrated tonight, from reimaginings of Wendy from Peter Pan to intergalactic cross-dressing mustachioed supervillains.
And if recent streaming comedy shows like Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt have taught us one thing, it's that auto-tuned theme songs are awesome.
The nominees for Best Female Performance in a Comedy are...
Best Female Performance in a Comedy. Zoe Chow, God Particles.
Planet might explode. Anyway, they're turning it on at the end of this week, so I guess you should try and get done everything you've been wanting to accomplish, because we're basically on the verge of an apocalypse.
Jackie Geary, John and Jen are married.
Invite them here.
You don't let me have friends here.
Do they have a wife?
Yeah.
Couple night.
Paula Rhodes, The New Adventures of Peter and Wendy.
Basically equates to being dead. Hi, we'll start digging my own grave as soon as I finish making this lovely dress of cat hair and tears.
Nefertari Spencer, Work in Progress, the series.
Tracy, get it together. Pee on a stick.
Kayla Lorette, Space Riders, Division Earth.
Space Riders? What, have one space rider kill another? Oh boy! That'll be good. All right, you rolling on this? Off me. Get.
And the award goes to Zoe Chow, God Particles.
Hi guys, thank you so much. This God Particles is just, I'm really sick on Mucinex right now and I feel a little loopy, but there's nothing better than making stories that you believe in with people that you love and respect. And thank you, Leland Montgomery, Claire Kaplan, Spencer Howard, for making God Particles with me. Please watch it, godparticles.tv. Thank you.
Please welcome the producer of My Two Black Girlfriends, Tanya Bershadsky, and from The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, Josh Robert Thompson.
Thank you very much. We're here to present the award for Best Costume Design.
Josh, I don't think I can go through with this.
What's wrong?
I just get really nervous. Look at all these people.
No, you don't have to worry about that. Listen, I got the perfect solution for that.
You do?
Sure. Look, when I get nervous, I just narrate what's happening, whatever's happening in the voice of Morgan Freeman. Makes me feel a lot better.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Here, you stand there and I'll narrate what you're thinking.
Oh, okay.
No matter what she did, no matter how hard she tried, it helps if you close your eyes. Tanya just couldn't get the words out. But we knew it was because of the devastatingly handsome man standing next to her, her palms sweating, beads of sweat on her fur.
That's not it?
It's for the dress. I'm not even here, ladies and gentlemen. And the nominees are...
Best costume design. Danny Casco, Augustin Aguirre, Studio Patna, and Jotar, Demonium. John Barrow, LARPs, The Series. Marshall Hall, My Two Black Girlfriends. Conchetta Verna and Manzi DeYoung, Player Piano. The Leak of Steam, The Leak of Steam.
And the award goes to...
I'll read it as Morgan Freeman. And the award goes to The League of Steam.
Wow, this is incredible. So there are so many amazing designers in this category. I just wanted to say I am honored to be a part of it. And all of you out there that are nominees, I bow to your greatness. My name is Trip Hope. I'm the producer of The League of Steam.
And I'm Stephen Boyd Morales. I was the wardrobe supervisor.
Right. And I just want to say a big thank you out there to all of our Kickstarter supporters, to the steampunk community. We also had great support from Donna Ricci at Clockwork Couture, Sword in the Stone. Thank you so much.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
What's happening with your face right now, Josh?
What do you mean? You talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you. What are you doing?
Doing my De Niro face.
Your De Niro face.
Yeah, Bobby D, Robert De Niro. Oh, you know what? You should try it.
You want to see her do the De Niro face? No way.
Yeah, just you'll be fine. Make it look like you just ate a lemon or you got indigestion or something.
Like Larry King
farted. You know, he just had brisket and he farted.
That I can understand.
Go ahead. Do that with your face. Go ahead.
So lemon?
Yeah, you're good. That's good. Now breathe through your nose like you got asthma. Now breathe slower. That's it. Slower. I am so turned on right now. That's it.
And the nominees for best makeup are...
Best makeup. Simone Ratzil, Rabbit FX Team, Demonium. Jen Rose and Sonia Cabrera, Real Housewives of Horror. Fernanda Orozco, Ride the Lightning, Vengeance. Christopher Mills, The Walking Fred.
Who the f***?
Carly Janelle, We Are Angels.
And the award goes to...
Just give me a second. What the hell are you looking at? All right. Simon Ratziel, Rabbit Effects Team, Demonium. Get up here right now. Get up here.
Wow. Thanks again. Simon. Sos un hijo de remil puta, sos lo mejor, chabón, te quiero. Spanish. Thank you for this. Simon and his team are great. Demonium is great. I'm feeling great. Thanks a lot.
Ladies and gentlemen, star of Chris and Josh, Shane Savage, and creator of Gold, David Nett.
G'day. We are here to recognize the grand art of production design.
Creating the overall look of a series is such a daunting task. I don't even know where to begin to do it justice.
Well, I came here all the way from Australia, so whatever you say, it better be good.
I got nothing. Can we just roll the video, please?
Best Production Design. Katie Most, The New Adventures of Peter and Wendy.
Track, but I got sleepy, and so I...
Megan Burns and Kia Herman, Player Piano. Sebastian Harder, Space Janitors. Eric Slatkin, Jay Holzer, Thirsty Four. Gabor Norman and Ryan Martin, Video Game High School.
And the award goes to...
So exciting.
Katie Moose?
Yeah, Katie!
The New Adventures of Peter and Wendy.
Thank you so much to the Academy of Web Television. I'm so honored to get this award. Thank you so much to the fans of New Peter and Wendy. We couldn't have done this without you. Thank you to my parents for their love and support. And thank you so, so much to the cast and crew of New Peter and Wendy. I love you all. And it's like a family, and I'm so honored to get this. It's a team award, and I'm so excited. Thank you so, so much.
It's our pleasure to welcome to the stage the founders of Bilbao Webfest, Rose of Dolls, and Oliver Mendy from Gifted Corporation.
Buonasera, buonasera a tutti, come stai? Procedemo a ricordare la norma della casa.
Good night, we're going to remind you of some basic rules.
SR Mercedes.
Please don't smoke.
Beer is good.
You can drink as much as you can.
Allons en France, les poteries, les gilets noirs, à leur laurier.
Just be friendly with the winners and with the non-winners.
Y ahora que tengo un momento con ustedes, me gustaría mostrarles a través de la crema de baba de caracol, Celton, que hará poder regenerar sus brazos de una manera...
And the nominees for the best non-English are...
Best Non-English Series. Demonium. Aposto de Sexo. Por el último round. Sin vida propia.
Me muero por decirte.
The Banks.
And the award goes to... Boludo Subaki, Daimonion! He's waiting.
Too many awards. Is he lost somewhere? Daimonium! Come on! Another one! No?
No.
Okay, so we're gonna accept this award for him, okay? And we're gonna walk out with it.
By Christopher Preska, who made Mercury Men. It was somebody doing science fiction in the web series space, and you know, that was inspiring and exciting.
I think Lonely Girl really kind of inspired me in the sense of it was kind of a narrative. People were wondering, you know, is this real, is it not? And it was such a unique way of using that medium.
There were a couple of web series called The Berg, and Sam Has Seven Friends, and Lonely Girl 15, and you know, there were several people doing scripted things from the website that I definitely took a cue from or was inspired by releasing my content at the same time. Because in the olden days, in 2006, it was not popular. YouTube just started.
There was no other web series that we knew about when we created The Berg. This was back in, we we started the process back in 2005. You know, it was a very new territory, and we knew that we had a great idea. We knew that we could write a great show, and we wanted to try to sell it to TV, and we thought, well, you know, let's put it up online.
YouTube was just beginning, and it seemed like a great way to, like, get directly to fans and to find an audience.
I stumbled upon the great web series Anyone But Me, which to this day is still one of my favorite web series I've ever seen. And so thank you, Tina and Susan, for being such an inspiration.
Sometimes you don't really make the decision to do something. It just becomes a natural progression, and I think the web was for me. What is so terrific about it is also the reach. There isn't anything that has that kind of scope. It's international, it's intergenerational, it's diverse.
The fact that we did it for 7 episodes that were 30 minutes each, and the fact that we got all this press and attention for it is amazing and wouldn't have happened in any other medium. So digital, while we didn't mean to sort of fall into it, has literally made our careers.
Porque eso nos permite una interacción directa con el espectador. Automáticamente nos hace saber qué le gusta, qué es lo que no le gusta, qué se puede mejorar, y entonces las distancias entre realizador y espectadores son mínimas, pero al mismo tiempo también inmediatas.
And I saw a place where I could just get it out there, I could see what people thought, and most importantly, I could express myself.
I was inspired to make a show for the web because on the internet you can write your own rules, and I really like to write my own rules.
The web itself inspires.
To present the award for Best Documentary or Educational Series, a special video from Larry King.
The internet has spawned more genres of video than anyone ever thought possible, but perhaps the most beneficial genre to society has been the documentary and educational category. From MOOCs to how to videos to insightful stories from around the world, we have all leapt forward into the new era of information, brought to you by, well, you. The nominees for Best Documentary or Educational Series are...
Best Documentary or Educational Series.
Arts and History.
Cranium Cookie.
Keep your brain fed with our edutastic adventures through science and the natural world.
Day of Gluttony. Everyday Economics.
Things change rapidly. This phenomenon is known as the hockey stick of human prosperity.
Man at Arms, Reforged.
So we've taken all of our scissors, we got them nice and bundled up, so now we're gonna give it a shot.
The future starts here.
Taking away. I'm Tiffany Schlain, I'm a mother, filmmaker, I founded the Webby Awards, and this series is about how the future doesn't start somewhere far off in the distance. The future starts here.
And the award goes to Cranium Cookie.
We are not the makers of Cranium Cookie, although I did have the pleasure of helping out a little bit. We shot some stuff, and I'm sure it's a real tight-knit community there in Toronto. Charlie and Danielle and Adriana, they are currently in Toronto right now watching. Hello, guys. They're in Kate's house. They're probably as drunk as the rest of us. You're going to have to speed that up. Okay, so they would like to thank Gloria, Steve, Rodney, Kelly, Tanner, a bunch of people, including people at the Ontario Science Centre, their parents, their teachers, supporters, of course, their audience, and more importantly, two guys accepting this award and the real reason Toronto has a web series community. That's us. Aww. Thanks, guys. I'm actually really... And man, now my suitcase is going to be heavy bringing this home to you, Charlie. Yeah, that's Charlie. Maybe a turtle will poo on him again. They're so happy at home, guys. Thank you.
Larry King looked fantastic, didn't he? There's been lots of emotions tonight. Lots of winners and lots of Lots of loo. Lots of not winners. Now, I know I have mixed drinks about my feelings. Well, before I get any more tipsy, or just drunk, let's bring out our next presenter. From Out With Dad, Vanessa's story, Lindsay Milton, and he literally wrote the book on web series, Mark's H. Pyle.
So Mark, you wrote a book on the pioneers of web series, right?
Yes, I did. It's called The Television on the Wild, Wild Web.
So who would you say is the most important pioneer?
Well, there isn't really just one person.
But if you had to pick?
Now, if I say one, I'll alienate everyone else.
No, come on, just give me a name, the ultimate pioneer.
Pocahontas?
That's fair. So the nominees for Best Writing Nonfiction are...
Best Writing, Nonfiction. Benny Fine, Raffi Fine, Kids React.
Everybody's doing the iceberg to tell.
Tiffany Schlein, Sawyer Steele, and Arnie Johnson. The Future Starts Here. Stacy Crawford, Amanda Toy, and Gabe Michael. Technium. Chips. Joe Bizarre, The Social Drinker.
Drink it at the time. The congregations of the Catholic Churches.
Joe Hansen, It's Okay to Be Smart. 200.
And the winner goes to Stacy Crawford, Gabe Michael, Amanda Toy, Technium.
Technicum.
Wow, this is awesome. Well, this is just a great time for all of us. The fact that we all have series that are made is great. We're just excited that we get to show our work and that we get to show what the future looks like and get to keep making things, yeah.
And thank you to everyone involved with our show and the IAWTV Awards and all of our biggest supporters, our family, our friends, our significant others. Yes. We're so excited, thank you.
The thing that I love most about Technium is that it shows us that if we can dream it, we can build it, and that the limits of innovation are endless. So,
thank you.
Thank you.
From Husbands, IAWTV Awards winners Jane Espenson and Brad Bell.
Hi. Writing drama is spinning words into emotional gold.
Oh, you mean spinning emotional gold into words?
Actually, I think I mean spinning golden words into emotions.
These nominees write good.
The nominees are...
Best Writing, Drama. Jay Ferguson and Jeremy Diamond, Guidestones, Sunflower Noir.
Bonitas. These words tell you all you need to know.
Tina Cisa Ward, so producing Juliet.
Away from Juliet as if we have some history. It isn't fair. There's no past between us, Henry.
That's because you can't distinguish the past from the present.
Eric Wan, The Division.
MZR 104, it's our chance to move up the ladder in The Division without waiting another 8 years. We need this.
Hannah Cheeseman and Julian Dizzotti, Whatever Linda.
To the plum position of making Ponzi-like promises to our most wealthy clients. Is there anything that you want to tell me,
Jim Monroe, Haphead.
Jen, Haphead Gano face comes in. The player is going to feel every punch. The player is going to feel every caress, just as if he were in the game world.
Jason Lever, out with
that. Trust me when I say it gets better.
Mr. Gladstone, shouldn't it just be better?
And the award goes to Tina Sess Award for producing Juliet.
I don't ever expect to win, so I don't know what else to say. Thanks so much to everybody in the IAWTV. I've been a part of this for so long, and it's still an incredible honor to be in this community. So thanks, everybody. And thanks to my producers, Allison Venor and Rochelle Dansel, and to my cast, who only complains a little about staying on book. Okay, thanks, guys. Cheers.
Writing comedy is very much the same as writing drama.
Right, because you're looking for the truth in the situation.
Right, and luckily truth is often ironic, ridiculous, or embarrassing.
And if it isn't, you've always got this. The nominees are...
Best Writing, Comedy. Amy Berg and Mike Sizemore, Caper.
For those keeping score at home between the TV, the bathroom door, and the refrigerator, there goes the last of our security deposits.
John Verrill, LARPs, the series.
No? Oh, okay, fair enough, yeah. I shoot him in the dick.
Christ. Sure you can hit a target that small?
Jake Green, Millennial Parents.
Care of our son.
Chill out, babe. She's just a candy kid.
A candy kid?
Candy with a K.
Okay, Candy with a K is a stripper name.
True, but in this case, it just means the girl's into electronic dance music.
Andy Signore and Spencer Gilbert, Honest Trailers.
Tumblr posts comes the romance that did for cancer what Twilight did for vampires.
Dan Byrne and Mark Little, Space Riders, Division Earth.
And acne you make commercials about. Kid goes on a commercial, talks about all the products he used to cure his leg acne.
That's not true.
That's what Philip Scott, he admitted it in a moment of passion.
Morgan Waters and Brooks Gray, The Amazing Gail Pyle.
I think you're just jealous that I'm having a good time for once. I'll tell you something. I had a sip of the boxed wine and it tasted good. I liked it. Very fruity.
And the award goes to... Oh my God, it's a tie.
Oh my God.
Caper,
it really is.
Caper and Space Riders Division Earth. Wow,
this is cool. I get to share. Thank you to my co-writer, Mike Sizemore, to IAWTV, to my producer, Pete Dress, to our amazing cast and crew on Caper, Beth, Abby, Hartley, Harry. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it. This is a great honor. Thank you.
Are you sharing?
Yeah. We're going to cut this in half. I get the top. Hi again. I just really want to thank Mark and Dan for an incredible show. I'm sure if they were here, they would really say how amazing they are and how talented they are. And they're hard at work at season two, and I should pay them more money, which I won't do, but I really appreciate their hard work. If you haven't seen the show or Guidestones, please check it out on Hulu. And thank you very much again. Have a good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, host of Late to the Game, Kristen Nedopak, and star of Night of the Zombie King, Stephanie Thorpe.
Hi.
From the Marx Brothers to Ed Sullivan and Saturday Night Live, variety series have had a long history in the entertainment world.
And that legacy is just as strong online, where creators are making some of the most diverse shows you will find anywhere.
And the nominees for Best Variety Series are...
Best Variety Series. Kids React.
Ice Bucket Challenge.
Host the Ice Bucket Challenge.
Ice Bucket Challenge.
Play Your Piano. Progress. Ask a Cam Harlot.
I just thought you were really in.
The Walking Fred.
Horrible. Where were all the walkers?
Hey, Fred, they need you on set for the Naked Kid.
What's trending?
Good evening. Good afternoon. Good morning. Wherever you are.
And the award goes to Player Piano. Tom, get back up here!
Wow, this is amazing. Everybody that works on the show works incredibly hard, so this means a lot. A year ago, Sonia, who's my partner in crime on this, we were trying to pitch this around everywhere. We were told no, no, hell no, fuck no, go to hell.
Yeah.
And then we decided to just do it ourselves. We started booking crew. We had no way to pay for it. Luckily, I figured out how to do that. And I want to thank... We did a Indiegogo campaign, and I want to thank our contributors who are awesome and amazing. And we would not be here without them.
Yes. And so, Tom really has a way of making a little go a long way. You should see what we actually have to work with, and Tom's amazing.
And I hate being on stage.
thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
It's awesome. Can you believe we had a tie? I'd always hope for a tie, just to see the presenter's reaction, like when Mark Wahlberg, you know, announced his sound editing Oscar that went to both Skyfall and Zero Dark Thirty, and he looked like he got the Willy Wonka golden ticket. It was like, oh, it's a tie, man. Say hello to your mother for me. So, of course, you know, there have been 6 ties at the Oscars and 10 at the Tonys and at the Golden Globes in 1989. Jodie Foster, Shirley MacLaine, and Sigourney Weaver had a 3-way tie. I remember those movies. It was The Accused, Madame Suzatska, and The Mist or something. Moving right along, she riveted us with her performance in Producing Juliet, and he turned One Night's Dream into Out With Dad. Please welcome Jenny Grace and Jason Lever.
Short-form creators often face the challenge of building a compelling world with developed characters using limited screen time.
But transmedia can give the creator a chance to do what they want to do best, and that's tell more story.
And it can also enhance the experience for the avid fan that just can't get enough of those favorite characters.
And that's what these 5 nominees have taken advantage of when it comes to transmedia.
Best Transmedia Experience. Carmilla. Emma Approved. Guidestones, Sunflower Noir. My Music. The New Adventures of Peter and Wendy.
And the award goes to... The New Adventures of Peter and Wendy.
Wow, okay. I want to thank the Academy. I want to thank Sean and our amazing actors who made playing those characters online so easy. And I want to thank Jenny and Kyle and Paula and the entire Pan family. Like Katie already said, we are a family.
Thank your mom.
And I want to thank my parents and my brother who are watching on the East Coast right now. And last but definitely not least, I want to thank the fans, because there is no category in any award show that is more dependent on them. Without them, everything I do is just a bunch of sound and fury.
No pun intended.
Thank you, and if you guys want to say anything.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Guild and the director of Real Housewives of Horror, Sandeep Parikh.
Woo! You guys, hosting. I will not take my shirt off. Not unless I get 30 likes right now. Then I'll take my shirt off. Guys, hosting is super hard. It's a really hard thing to do. But inhabiting someone else's body is also extremely hard, like being the parasite, you know? So whether you're implanted by a face alien or chew your way out of their intestines or like crawl into someone's ear and wrap yourself around their cerebral cortex or you're burrowed through the back of their neck and fusing yourself into their central nervous system, I mean, that's super tough, okay? Even harder, though, is being the host. Having the alien parasite inside of you, controlling your thoughts and eating you from the inside out. These five nominees have done just that. And the nominees for live host are...
Best Live Host. Kristen Burt, AfterBuzz TV's So You Think You Can Dance after show.
You have a bad attitude or something happens, it's like, ooh, 21 remain, so it kind of gives you an idea.
John Campia, AMC Movie Talk.
You will lose count within 5 minutes of how many little girls are in Elsa and Anna dresses. Mm-hmm.
Jeff Burns, Tanya Dodds, and Nicole Wright, Super Geeked Up.
Dude, Amy, I wish someone would hit on me.
Mike Rotman, Take My Bitcoins.
I'm going for it. It's the internet.
Yeah, you got it.
Diaphragm?
I would have gone diaphragm or IUD.
Well, you're all pushing.
Sharon Lazar, What's Trending?
Daily and live from the YouTube house.
Do you ever think about writing a D&D movie?
Absolutely, are you? Yeah.
And the award goes to... Jeff Burns, Tanya Dodds, Nicole Wright for Super Geeked Up.
This is really crazy. Thank you so much. Thank you so much to the members of the IAWTV for voting for us, and of course for Frostbite Pictures, and just every guest from the web series community who's been part of our show, because without you, we wouldn't have a show. So thank you so much. And also, especially to our fans, they keep us going every single week. They inspire us, and they really make doing this thing, like, this is our job and it's amazing. We just love everybody. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
I don't deserve those cheers. Apparently host does not refer to the parasitic relationship between a human and an alien monster, which would have been super cool. John Hurt should have won Best Live Host, but that's fine, whatever. The nominees for Best Pre-Recorded Host, that makes more sense to me now. They are...
Best Pre-Recorded Host. We are John Campia, AMC Mailbag.
Which is great. I mean, we moved into the space, but now this past week, we actually launched some of the new shows, which I'm so excited about.
Larry King. Larry King Now.
It's bad. I understand completely.
I thought we were going to lie.
What was your first name?
Aliyun.
I like Akon better.
I thought Larson.
Kristen Nedopek, Late to the Game.
Anybody hear me? I heard that Cullen's in love with you.
Hey, thanks, Chatty Cathy, for making me relive this embarrassing moment.
Oh. Sean Thomas, Local Flight.
Been
desert.
Will Wheaton, Tabletop.
Thirstiest will go first. We discussed this before we rolled the cameras, and I've been drinking water all day, and John's drinking water right now.
And the winner. Oh, sorry, I'm not supposed to say that because everybody's a winner. They told me that backstage, and then I literally just said it. Oopsie, it says winner on the card. Come on, and the award goes to Kristen Nedepak, late to the game.
Okay, WTF, I'm sorry. Okay, so a few months ago, my friend and I were just like randomly in the audience for The Price is Right, the show that I've watched my entire life. And I was sitting in the audience and all of a sudden my name was called and I had this moment where I freaked out. I was like, me, what? And that's kind of how I feel right now. So I'm a little bit flabbergasted because all of the people that were nominated tonight are my idols. Will, John, Larry, you're so incredible. I did not expect to be standing here. Thank you so much to everyone at IAWTV for voting for me and for making me feel like part of your family. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you. And it's my birthday.
There was this show that I really loved that I'm not sure how many people saw called Take Me Back. Wonderful production values, incredibly cinematic in how it was presented.
You know, my old 30-something producer colleague who did Quarter Life. When I heard about it, I just thought, wow, you know, this is cool.
Quarter Life really helped us kind of understand at the time, you know, episode length, how many episodes to do. We really kind of picked their brains about as much as we could, and that really helped kind of set us on our path.
Ask a Ninja was one of the first ones that I saw that went crazy. And I was like, that's cool. They get people commenting on it. I want people to comment on my stuff.
And when I saw Prom Queen, I was blown away. This is like real television broken up into small short films or short stories for the web, and this is exactly what we want to do.
And then there's a show called The Berg that was out roughly around the same time, and they had an article written about them in Wired, and it was kind of like, oh, wait, other people are starting to do this, and this might be a thing now. I would say that's probably my earliest memory of an inspiring series.
It seemed kind of the perfect thing for the internet because we knew that Gawker and Gothamist and the New York Times and all these local New York institutions would love a show that would make fun of this gentrification process.
I definitely remember Prom Queen. Prom Queen was like such a good source for me. It was like I was so excited because there was another teen show and I can like look at another teen show. Totally not the same show, but I love that show. It was a great show, and they were so smart, and they had such a great website. Everything was laid out so well, you know, so it was like they were just a great resource, and so thank you, Chris and company.
Big Fantastic and Prom Queen, they're the guys that inspired us to create the show. So if you have a problem with any of our shows or any of our work, they are to blame. Talk to Chris and Caleb if you can get him on the phone now.
I was inspired by a lot of people to get online and start making stuff. Mostly by the other members of Big Fantastic, which is Doug Cheney, Chris Hampel, Ryan Wise. I've always been inspired by Zadie Diaz and Steve Wolf. I've always been inspired by Felicia Day. Who hasn't? What drew me most into creating stuff online was this ability to find an audience anywhere in the world. Anywhere in the world, people could watch your stuff and they could watch it tomorrow. When you remove the wall between yourself and the audience, you can do almost anything.
And now, the star of the Banks, Xavier Huard, and the creator of Drifter series, Jason Brazier.
Web series creators often have to beg, borrow, and steal.
And that is just to eat.
So, tonight's nominees thought big,
but spent little.
The nominees for Best Microbudget Series are...
Best Microbudget Series, God Particles. High and low.
Well, everyone else like me and you, we're on struggle street.
But every industry has its unfair stuff.
I understand how it works.
I know.
But what if you don't get the big part?
Jared posts a personal. Out of time.
It's a Sumi.
Me too.
Chris, you can't tell anyone about this.
The Gambit.
Come on.
And the awards goes to God Particles.
Hi guys, we're really thrilled to be here with such exciting artists, and we're so thankful to have been awarded this award. And thank you so much to Claire and Zoe, even if you are in Mucinex, and thank you so much. Thank
you. Please welcome to the stage IAWTV Chairman Emeritus and executive producer of Mom Cave TV, Jay Sibley Law, and the director of the web files, Sandra Payne.
So Sib and I, Sib, where are you? Where are you, Sib?
Whew.
What are you doing over there?
Sandy, what are you doing over there?
Come on over here. I think this is a good example of why this category is so important, because there are a lot of pieces that need to come together smoothly, and we do look to the directors, great directors, to make that happen.
All of the nominees for Best Director for Nonfiction have done just that.
Best Directing Nonfiction. Aaron McLean, Blitz.
Cause you're about to get blitzed. That's right.
Benny Fine and Rafi Fine, Kids React.
No, no, I...
A big kid should just watch.
Tom Gray, Player Piano. Antonio Guajardo, Por el Último Round. Robert Angelo, Roads and Rides, People, Places, Passion.
Went down a wheel and had a spring.
And the award goes to... Tom Gray for Player Piano.
Hey guys, this is not my award. The reality is that I work with so many incredibly talented, mostly women, some men, but incredibly talented people who bring their talents to Player Piano that make it really what it is. And the only other thing I wanted to say is, we're talking about pioneers tonight. A couple years ago, I was working a really terrible job analyzing the income and expenses of laundromat businesses, which is a thing, and I saw a web series called The Legend of Neil. And that web series, I never knew that The Legend of Zelda and masturbation jokes could really inspire me to do something with my life. So, Sandeep, you're here. Drinks on me tonight. Thanks.
Okay, it's my pleasure to introduce now, here's the IAWTV award winner and director of Larry King Now, Scott Brown, and director of My Two Black Girlfriends and director of tonight's show, the lovely Jen Page.
Hi. Directing a comedy can be challenging. It's a fine balance between
timing
and helping your actors bring...
Be funnier.
What are you doing?
I'm directing. The nominees for best directing in a comedy are...
Best directing, comedy. Brandon Rabbit, Bad Timing.
One. Get...
Swiped, killed, massacred, slaughtered to pieces. I'm not good at charades.
Sean Becker, Hench. Zandy Parikh, Real Housewives of Horror.
Into me.
I guess it was the first time I had ever thought of taking a female.
Morgan Waters and Brooks Gray, The Amazing Gail Pyle.
It's tape to sell.
Freddie Wong and Matt Arnold, Video Game High School.
He doesn't realize that I'm a sociopath who cares more about video games than me.
And the winner is, no surprise, Sean Becker, Hench. Where is he?
He's here.
I know he's here.
He's coming, he's coming.
Leave it to Sean to be the back of the room. The bad kid in school. Run. You're ruining my show.
You can't.
I will accept this award on your behalf.
I wonder if I can drink this. It's about the right size. I wanted to say thank you to everyone involved with Hench. This show was just a blast to make. I want to thank all of my family and friends, not for tolerating me, but for supporting me. And then I want to thank all my other friends for tolerating me. So thank you all very much. And to the writer, creator, star, Daryl Crittenden, dude, thank you so much. And please, 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 let's do this again. Thank you.
Whether it's a story where video games train you for real-life combat, an alternate universe where magic and technology collide, I love magic, by the way, or one in 1978 about a broke 30-something, a director's job is to bring life to a story in a real and accessible way.
Often bridging the gap between creative vision and the practical needs of a production, the director is in a unique position to shape a series like no other. They can tease a performance out of an actor, give guidance for a particular wardrobe choice, or choose the exact right shot to tell a story. The nominees for Best Directing in a Drama are...
Best Directing, Drama. Toby Wilkins, Chosen.
Josie Acosta, Ghost.
What's going on?
Box.
He's cute.
Pablo Javier Perez, Demonium. Tate Young, Hothead.
Let's go! Can we move?
Adam Kosh, The Banks.
No!
Matt Eastman, Whatever Linda.
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 Linda. Hi.
And the award goes to Matt Eastman, Whatever Linda. Congratulations.
Great job.
Hi,
Hi, everyone. I'm not Matt. I'm Julian Dezzati. I'm the co-creator of the show, but there's Matt. Look how beautiful he looks. He's so nice. He's back in Toronto, and he told me to accept this award for him. He just wanted to thank, Toronto. Yeah. I'm by myself, too, like the Aussies, so don't be shy. Unless you're a hooker, then I've got $3 bills, so probably not going to have a good time. Thank you. He wanted to thank Hannah Cheeseman, my co-creator as well, our co-executive producer, Mackenzie Donaldson, his lovely DOP, Rob Scarborough, and our executive producers, Kevin Saffer and James Millward. Matt comes from the commercial world, but he wanted to break out and do something new. And I got to tell you, he just really, he did a really great job. And he thanks especially the Academy for being so generous and giving him this award. Thank you. Good night.
And now, God Particles, Zoe Chow, and Real Housewives of Horrors, Bria Grant.
My question is, who is winning the award for the drunkest table tonight? Great, okay, cool. A disturbed castaway, an awkward biochemist, a troubled detective, a geeky chef, and a single dad. These are the roles our actors bring to life in the drama category, with performances varied as the characters they play. The nominees are...
Best Male Performance in a Drama. Sean Blaney, Far, the web series.
That's where it ends.
That's not a buff.
Jonathan Robbins, Haphead.
Failsafe use for clones. When they get out of control, you say the phrase and they die.
Really?
Jonathan Robbins, out with Dad.
Nathan? My daughter came out to me months ago.
Ed Robinson, Pairings, Season 2.
But I thought she was married, so I blew it. I blew it! Like, I blew everything!
Xavier Wad, The Banks.
See, King Saluna. It's a skin smack, don't ever. I guess I'm missing some of the money.
And the award goes to Sean Blaney for Fire the Web Series. Ireland.
Holy moly, I really wasn't expecting this. I'll try and speak slowly because I know my accent is unintelligible. Thank you so much to Aidan Largy, who I sat down last year with and came up with this in a coffee shop, and now we're in Las Vegas. Thank you very much to the IAWTV for the best reason to ever come to Vegas. It's an amazing city. Thank you to RTV, RTE, and Sterling. You can watch Far on RTE Player now. Please do. It's great. And the biggest thank you of the night to my wife, Emma, for such a lovely weekend here in Vegas. Thank you so much. Have a good night, guys. Cheers.
From Clutch, please welcome Elitza Bacco and Matthew Carberry.
Yeah, they did. The best performances are the ones that stick with you long after watching.
They can be tenacious, enduring, riveting, or vulnerable. Pulling at your heartstrings or keeping you on the edge of your seat.
Or perhaps all of those things all at once, right?
Right.
Like, you know, these five performances have inspired us all.
The nominees for Best Female Performance in a Drama are...
Best Female Performance in a Drama, Tanya Nolan, Grayson Earth 1.
And I
spit on as a child for begging on the streets of what you so fondly call home.
Chloe Rose, teenagers.
Reed, wait, are you...
Stop, all right? This is your fault, and because of you, I'm gonna have pelvic pains and my...
Rivka Ravenwood, Star Trek Phase 2, New Voyages.
It's time for you to go.
Titania Alexis, Sid 2030.
Done. It has been the minute you set foot on that plane with her.
That's not fair. You don't know what happened.
I don't care.
Lindsay Middleton, Vanessa Story.
I don't have anyone to call.
Hoping they'll call you?
Guess so.
And the award for best female performance in drama goes to... Lindsay Middleton, my darling. Oh yeah, it's yours, baby.
Hi, I don't know. Thanks. Jason Lieber, because I wouldn't be here without you. Thank you to everyone who is here for doing this and creating things online that matter and make you laugh and make you feel things. Thanks. I don't even know. Mom, thank you, because I literally wouldn't be here without you. Yay!
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the stars of Caper, Leverage, and the upcoming USA drama Complications, Beth Risegraf.
The term drama comes from, as you might expect, Greek origins. It means to do. It's easy to have an idea and only talk about it, but the heroes are the people who take that idea and make it happen. They tell us their stories, and in doing so, affect the way we think. They move us, they challenge our ideas, they take us on a ride. They show us a version of the world that only they can tell. The creators of these five shows don't just talk about creating, they do.
Best drama series, Eternus.
Oh my God. They've been tracking us.
Control.
No, of course not. Can I have a biscuit then? I'd hate to see you screw this up.
Guidestone Sunflower Noir.
Everyone that I care for dies, and you're gonna die too.
Sequestered.
Sequestering the 12 of you for the remainder of the case. Godspeed, and through you may justice be served.
Whatever, Linda.
You've managed to edge your way to the plum position of making Ponzi-like promises to our most wealthy clients. Is there anything that you want to tell me, Linda?
And the award goes to Whatever Linda.
Thank you so much, everyone. I just wanted to say thanks to Roger Bart. I saw him do with the producers like 10 years ago, and it was one of the best things I've ever seen. He's been really great tonight. I want to thank the IAWTV, who's been so welcoming, and all of you. It's such a great community to get to make cool shit, and hopefully we can make more. Please go to whateverlinda.com to watch our show. Sorry, I've been running. Whew. And they just gave me brownies, so that was pretty good, too. Not hash brownies, real brownies. But also, finally, most importantly, Canada is just very, very supportive as a country with our artists. And this would not have happened without the support of the IPF, the Independent Production Fund, and the OMDC. So thank you to them. And one more round of applause for Secret Location, who's our executive producer, James Millward, who allowed us to work and sort of hone our creative vision in a digital space. And they've just made a fantastic website. So again, go to that website. That would be great. And thanks to the people over there at my table. They've just been so lovely and welcoming, and they said hi to me, and thank you so much. And finally, I want to thank my parents who encouraged me to become a lawyer, and this is what happened. So hopefully this is some consolation. And if this gets me a bottle of water, that would be great. I don't have $5. But thank you so much, guys. Thank you.
And now, to present the award for Best Comedy Series, please welcome IAWTV award-winning director, Sean Becker, and multi-platinum selling songwriter, Jason Charles Miller. Guys? Guys? Okay. And the nominees for Best Comedy Series are...
Best Comedy Series. Honest Trailers.
Oh, that's Ansel. He's so hot right now. Sick McLovin. Jurassic Mom. That guy who showed his butt a lot on True Blood. Douche Pants. And Tibbs.
Only in LA.
I mean, maybe with heels, right?
No.
Aposto de Sexo.
Jingle Bell.
Chega. No.
Pero.
Real Housewives of Horror
gives you corpses.
Corpse party!
28 days later?
We get it burning.
Yes!
Space Riders, Division Earth.
For a second. Yeah, your little friend has a big brain now, so.
I didn't write the song.
Clearly favored you.
Don't blame that on me.
No,
okay, you know what? We're gonna talk about this later.
Papa's gonna go pound this dog back to the pound shit.
Seriously? And the award goes to... It's a tie. Real Housewives of Horror and Honest Trailers.
Thank you.
Awesome. Should we talk at the same time?
Yeah, I don't know.
Just want to thank the Academy for this tiny scale pipe organ. And thanks, series creator Andy Signor, Defy Media, John Bailey, the voice of Honest Trailers, this guy who edits them all, my girlfriend, I promise we'll eat soon. And let's go party, guys.
Okay. Man, I tell you, nothing makes me happier than a silent bit like that. That's the bravest stuff. I love that. And it's too bad the camera wasn't on them while they exited in stage terror. That was worth the whole evening to me. I don't know why. I have a very peculiar sensibility, and that makes me so happy. Thank you so much for being here. And now, please, just go home and make love to a pioneer. You know, or if you're watching at home, just fantasize about it. And thank you to the entire awards team, the New Media Expo, all of the fantastic volunteers for your time and your energy. There's never been a better time to be a creator and share your passion. So go out and create, watch, and inspire. Become the new pioneers and help change the face of storytelling. We'll see you online, all right? Have a great night. Thank you so much, everybody. Good night.